So we are back after what I feel was a very strong showing in the preseason in this year here in 2020. Here we sit at week one of the regular season, ready to take on the New York Giants. I do remember that the New York Giants picked AJ Epenesa with the first pick in the draft at defensive end. He's going to be a little bit of a problem. We're going to have to watch out for him because he is a very, very talented young defensive lineman. But as we all know, the one guy that you always have to look out for whenever you're taking on the New York Giants is the man Saquon Barkley himself. Quite possibly one of the most OP running backs in the league, if not the most OP running back in the league, maybe behind Zeke. You could argue Zeke. But this guy is just an absolute workhorse, man. He's an animal. He's incredible. He's a guy that, like, I dream of having on this team. But our rookie showed a lot of promise in the preseason, and that includes our boy JT23, Jonathan Taylor at running back. He was very good, and it's going to be on him to really carry most of the load here with Ronald Jones being out for at least the next 4 weeks. But I think that the most pressure of all is probably going to be on Jake Fromm, okay? So he is starting right out of the gate. We've decided to go with him as the starter. Jake Fromm is going to have all the pressure on him to perform well enough, at least, for us to feel like he's the answer for our franchise quarterback of the future. Because make no mistake about it, I have absolutely no problem going out there next season and drafting a guy like Justin Fields if Jake Fromm does not put forth the type of performance that I feel would be acceptable for a rookie quarterback that was drafted in the first round. So the expectations are going to be a little bit high for me, and I'm sure they're going to be high for you guys as well. Now let me put that into perspective just a little bit. I'm not trying to say that I want this guy to go out there and break rookie passing records or anything like that, but what I would like to see is a decent touchdown to interception ratio and a guy that's not losing games for us repeatedly. Of course, there's going to be some growing pains. There's been growing pains with every quarterback in the NFL. But like I said, if Fromm is absolutely awful, I have no problems whatsoever pulling an Arizona Cardinals and going straight for a rookie quarterback in next year's draft in the first round. And that is part of the reason why I wanted to give him this full season right from jump to show us what he's really worth. I wanted to give him the full 16 games, go out there and show us that he can be the quarterback of the future for this franchise. And then, of course, the man himself on the defensive side of the ball, our boy Chase Young, that's the guy that I'm expecting to compete for Defensive Rookie of the Year. You guys are going to be very, very impressed with this kid when it's all said and done. But anyway, talking about all that is actually a perfect segue into us setting our season goal for 2020. It's really hard for me to kind of know what we should set our season goal at, but I think it's pretty obvious that, making it to the Super Bowl is where we should be. Nah, of course. Of course I'm joking, okay? Of course I'm joking. But 4 wins, I think, is reasonable for a team that just relocated, a team that's got a lot of rookies at a lot of important positions, most notably quarterbacks. So we're going to commit to 4 wins on this season. Last thing we want is to put Bruce Arians' job at risk. And I just noticed that the Jaguars have sniped a player from our practice squad. MJ Stewart Jr. is now gone and signed onto their regular roster. You could argue that maybe I shouldn't have put him on the practice squad, but we are pretty set at safety right now. I'm pretty confident with our safeties. And then, of course, the message that nobody ever wants to get, your defensive coordinator wants to discuss the X-Factor running back that you're going to be taking on in this week's game in week one, none other than Saquon Barkley. Let's see what our defensive coordinator, Humphrey McKinney, has to say to prepare us for this game. Hey, coach, what's the game plan for Saquon Barkley? The guy is an absolute home run hitter. If we don't lock down our gaps, he's liable to score from anywhere on the field. How do you want to handle him? As much as I would love to say neutralize him, I'm going to have to say slow him down probably because, honestly, I think Teddy Bridgewater is their quarterback for this game, and he is at least competent, so we can't commit all of our attention to just Saquon. So it says, yeah, I like that approach. We don't have to stop him. We just have to contain him. Let's do it. So, yeah, that's going to have to be our game plan, to just slow him down as much as possible. Let's see what the game goal is, though. Game day goal, beat the New York Giants and hold them to one or fewer rushing touchdowns. I think that that's at least doable. That's at least doable. And then also, our last order of business before we hop into the game, we have some players that we can upgrade before we jump into week one. So the first man up with an upgrade point is our boy Minkah Fitzpatrick. He got himself one upgrade point during the preseason. I assume that's where it's from. One skill point available. Let's go ahead and use that. I think it's kind of a no-brainer that we're going to go ahead and spend this skill point on hybrid. It is a scheme fit. I would only put it probably in either zone or hybrid, but I think hybrid is perfect here. So hybrid is going to get us 83 overall, first of all, but plus one to excel, plus one to awareness, plus one to man, and plus two to tackling. We'll take it. All right, and here we go. This is what we were waiting for. We got one upgrade point for our boy Jake Fromm. Of course, field general is always appealing. with these upgrade points, but strong arm, hoping, man, I'm hoping and praying that we can get an upgrade to his throw power. That's what I'm talking about, getting that throw power up. Plus one to throw power, plus one to throw accuracy deep. That helps us tremendously. Next on the list, our boy Emmanuel Hall. Of course, we just got the throw accuracy deep, so we're going to go with deep threat for this one. He goes up to a 69 overall, I'm sorry. Plus two to awareness, plus two to deep route, plus one catching traffic, and plus one to medium route. Not a problem. Love all four of those. And then our last two guys, John Kaminsky, the left end, and then Anthony Nelson, the left outside linebacker. For Kaminsky, it's a no-brainer. We're going to power rusher for this one. Let's see what we get him. He goes up to a 68, plus one in Excel, plus three in awareness, really good, plus one in play rec, plus one in power moves. Really, really, really loving those four categories there going up. And then last but not least, of course, we've got Anthony Nelson, the outside linebacker. I think we're going to go with a run stopper. Plus two in awareness, plus one in block shedding, plus one in play rec, plus one in tackling, and plus one in zone coverage. We've got five categories. Love to see that. I think this all worked out perfectly with all of our upgrade points. That reminds me, one other thing I wanted to show you guys, since we are on the subject of upgrades, is that the XP sliders are almost completely default. Now, I see a lot of people that upgrade their XP sliders to, like, you know, 125, 130, some even higher than that. For me, I want it to be a challenge for our guys to go up in overall, and I want it to be like a hell of a challenge, if you know what I mean. I want it to be as realistic as possible. I want there to be, you know, a large possibility for guys to be busts, because that happens. That stuff happens in real life all the time. So what I did was I chose two categories to buff for the offensive side and the defensive side of the ball. For the offensive side of the ball, I went with tackles at 115. Defensive side, I went with defensive ends at 115, but I also boosted the quarterbacks up to a 115 XP slider because we've got Bruce Arians, the quarterback whisperer, as our head coach. I think that that makes sense to boost that up to 115. But like I said, for the sake of realism, I didn't touch anything else. Everything else stays at 100, which is where it starts off at when you start the franchise. So I don't think there's anything left to do other than to jump into our week one matchup. Start of the regular season against the Giants. It's our home opener. It's the season opener. We're going to skip over training, but we do have Jake Fromm, JT23, and Chase Young as our priorities. As you can see, like I said, we're at home. Let's go ahead and simulate the training for now. And we're going to play the full game, full 60-minute experience. Of course, it's not going to be a full 60 minutes because we play on like 10-minute quarters. Still, nonetheless, I don't simulate any of it, no matter what the circumstances are. I'm not going to obviously put you guys through all of it, but I'm going to play all of it myself. If you guys thought I got pumped up for the preseason, wait till you see how I am with the regular season, man. It is time now to see if our young core can handle Saquon Barkley, Teddy Bridgewater, Jabril Peppers. It is time now, boys, for the 2020 home opener. Let's get it. Oh, here we go. Our fans are into this, man. They are ready. They are pumped. And look at our boys. Look at our boys. I don't know about you, but to me, our boys look ready to go. I mean, they're about as pumped up as they could possibly be in the tunnel. But wait. Forgot something. Do you hear that? You guys hear that? That's the sweet sound of no announcers. No announcers. You guys asked for it. You guys got it. Here come our boys in our home opener, our season opener, regular season game one for us, man. This is like I'm telling you, this pumps me up more than anything. You guys saw how pumped I got about the preseason. Imagine how excited I am for this. They're gonna highlight Evan Engram, but he's not the best man on the field today. I'll tell you that right now. I'll tell you that right now. Shout out Travis, by the way, man, for your birthday. Got rid of those announcers. And, of course, for everybody else, too, though. So they're going to start it off with Teddy Bridgewater. That's going to be their guy for now. Like I said, man, he's at the very least, he's a serviceable quarterback. And we got to watch out for any shenanigans. We don't need these weekly game breakdowns. All right, let's start this thing off strong. I know our defense, man, our defense is nasty, and it showed in the preseason that this defense is very, very good. We just got to come out and hit these guys in the mouth early. Saquon Barkley, of course, going to start it off. Okay, is that like 3 yards? Second and six here, let's see. Oh, if you'd have dropped back the pass, that Chase Young was coming for him, baby. All right, we got him in a very early third down and four here, boys. Be really nice if we get him in a three and out. They got what they got. Oh my God, he was wide open. How does he get so? He got a soft spot in the zone there. Who is that? Was that Jermaine Curse? All right, man. Let's show out here. Let's show out. Barkley again. Nowhere to go, baby. Nowhere to go. Levante David and Carl Nassib right there on the stop. Second down and 9. I know, man. It keeps on bringing up Chase Young's first career sack. We're gonna use him until we get it, man. We're going to user him until we get it. Oh, he fell there. Still nowhere to go for Saquon. What do you got, Teddy? Third and 5, man. Got him in another third down. Chase was coming. Oh, we took a beautiful route to push him back to the inside. And that's going to bring up 4th and 1. Force them to kick the field goal early on here on the first drive. All right, Bruce, get the boys pumped up, man. Down 3-0. Come on, Jake the Snake. Let's see what you can do on your first drive. This is first drive for these rookies, man, in the regular season action. We're going to start it off with a pass, see if we can catch them off guard here early. They might be expecting a run here. Oh, Mike Evans. Mike Evans, baby. He is just old reliable. You know, I had Rager open on that play. But I missed him. JT? That's what I'm talking about. Nice little 4 yards. All right, man. We're in a 3rd and 6. We got JT going in motion up on a wheel route here. That should be able to draw some defenders off. Love to convert these early here, man. Set the tone. I see Mike Evans. Cut up. Come on, fight for it. Oh, my God. He's short. He's definitely going to be short there. Yeah, 4th and 1. Come on, Bradley. Bradley Pinion. I'm going to give you a nickname here if you get this right. Is he Bradley Pinion side your own 10? He is Bradley Pinion side your own 10. My man. Hopefully next time he can be Bradley Pinion side your own 5. Saquon Barkley. Come on, man. We got to get on this guy, man. Do not let him tear us up. I'm not afraid of Teddy Bridgewater. I'm just really not. Saquon, slip and tag. You can't try to leg tackle this man. He's just... Come on, Teddy, show us something. Show us what you got. I know what Saquon's all about. And he's going nowhere. We know what he's about, but they know what our defense is about. Maybe not. Maybe not. Let's go, boys. 3rd and 2. Show him something. Did we stop him? They gave it to him. All right. 1st and 10. Oh, he's wide open. Evan Engram. That was my fault. That was my blown coverage. I had Devin White. We got to worry about Evan Engram too, man. Especially in red zone situations and third down situations. Anything short. But we're in a 3rd and 9. Whoa. Curse. No awareness that the ball's coming. All right. I think it might be JT 2-3 time here, baby. Let's go. All right, it's Peppers on the tackle. Nice play. Nice play. 3rd and 6. Let's see what we got. Empty backfield. I think I like Shaheen over the middle here on the slant. Let's see. Got him. Got him, coach. Let's go, baby. First down. Haven't had much luck on first downs today. I really like He's open. He's wide open. Cannot leave him. You cannot leave him. That's going to be a first down every time. That's too easy. All right, let's see. Milestone. Get first career rushing touchdown with JT. We're trying, baby. We're trying. Up the middle, not much there. All right. Let's see. We need to get Evans 220-plus yard catches to get in the zone. JT? Nice run there. Nice run. Almost 8 to get us the first. Got us in a 4th down again. Let's see if Bradley can do his thing again here on the punt. Pinion side your own 5. Pinion! Oh, it's at the 2! Let's go, baby! My man Bradley Pinion side your own goal line. See, they got 98 yards to go if they want to score here. Barkley, no way, baby. That's backward. 99 now. Now you got 99 to go. Devin White, my man. Show us something, D. Show us something, D. Harrison putting that hit. I believe we can get a safety. I believe in it. All right. That's just as good, though. We stopped them. It's going to be 4th and 8-ish. There we go. They're punting the ball away. All right. Let's not waste this fantastic field position here. I see Godwin. He held on to it. He is reliable, my man. 5 of 8 for Fromm so far. All right, so we should be able to at least tie the game up here. Let's see what we got with JT. The last thing I'm going to do is abandon the running game. Still not giving us much, though. Third down. It's a big third down. I like Rager here. Got him. What? Threading the needle, man. That was an accurate, very nice pass by Fromm. Give me something to be proud of here, JT. Let's go, baby. All right, I do like the outside runs. That one didn't work out, but I think the outside's where it's at. Maybe outside runs where we're not in the shotgun. But for this one, there we go. Boy, Mike Evans, man. He's a beast. First and goal. All right, Oilers. 2 yards to go to our first touchdown as a franchise. OJ Howard! Bruh, Howard had that in his hands, but let's see if JT can bail us out here. Oh, God, he pushed the defender right into me, man. Come on. 2 minutes to go in the half. Third and goal. I trust in the run game. Oh, man, that got blown up immediately. They call a timeout. We're kicking a field goal. Come on, baby, I need you to destroy this ball. Right through the uprights, tying it up. My guy destroying. Alrighty, man. They're gonna try to make something of this. Oh, Harrison. That's Golden Tate over the middle. But Harrison, man, you gotta jump for that one, baby. You gotta jump for that, and they're gonna go no huddle here. Come on, Devin White. Got the man across the middle. Who is that? 87? That's Sterling Shepard that time. They're probably going to go no huddle again. Nope. Showing blitz. We're going to drop back, though. Where's Chase Young? I don't... No! Golden Tate got wide open, my boys. All right, let's get a little taste of Jake Fromm in a two-minute drill here. We've got less than a minute to go. I see Evans. Nice, that should be a first. Whew. Second and inches. I would love to score here, man. Oh, I had Evans too, but that's perfectly fine. He dropped it. All right, boys, we need to really, really hang on to the ball here. Can't fault Godwin, though. He's done very well. Held on to it for way too long there. Clock is ticking. I don't want to use this timeout just quite yet, though. Nice, OJ. My man. My guy, OJ. Timeout. Timeout. Big catch there. Very big catch to put us in field goal range. Alrighty, De La Haye. This one from 47. It's up. And it's money. No doubter on that one. My man's got legs on him. So we're down 10-6 at halftime. But take a look at this. This presentation is crazy. I've not actually seen this yet, but look at this. So Atlanta up 28-7 on the Lions, and then you got Cincinnati up 21-10 over Washington. I really like the way they've done this little halftime presentation here, especially without the announcers. All right, my boys, we start off with the ball in the second half here. Start off with the outside run. There he goes. Oh my God, should have kicked it to the outside. Let's go no huddle and try to get that play again. Oh, I called the wrong play. All right, no biggie. It's okay. We'll still go with the run. No, you know what? Let's pass it. Oh! Whoa! Adam Shaheen! My guy with the one-handed catch! All right, we're in a 3rd and 10 here. Still down 10-6. I would love to. I mean, we at least need a. Oh, bro. Please. Please. Bro, Mike Evans had green grass. Nothing but green grass in front of him there. Another good punt. Pinion side. Your own five again. Man, my guy. Best punter in the league. We've only allowed 10 points through the first half. Done a very good job on everybody. Very good keeping Evan Ingram in front of us. Come on, Chase Young. Somebody want to tackle him? Thank you. Thank you very much. Ronnie Harrison, Greedy Williams, anybody. All right, it would be fantastic if we just did not let Barkley run free here. Or Golden Tate. God, I hate him. He got the touchdown on us, and now he's doing even more damage to us here. Got him in a third down. Let's go. I was on it. God, I was on that, man. Ingram, he's tough. He is a tough tight end to stop. You know, Evan Ingram is just going to continue to be their bailout. We got him in another 3rd and 9. I guarantee you they're going to him. And they do. He doesn't get it. He doesn't get it because our safety, Ronnie Harrison, the young man from Alabama, is there for it. All right, they got the touchdown lead here. So we can still tie it, man. We've been holding them. Pressure was on there. OJ Howard, let's go, baby. Let's go. Run him over. Running people over. Asserting his dominance. Can I get a shout out for OJ Howard, man? He's a beast. Let's go, JT. The outside runs is where it's at, man. We're going to go right back to it. Right back to it to the other side here. Come on, hurry it up. If it continues to work, I'm just going to make them stop it. Keep doing it till they stop it. Alrighty. Play action. There's my boy Mike Evans. Run him over, baby. Run his ass over. Like it's nothing. All right, we're going to go with the play action post shot here. Can Evans get open here, man? That is the question. Oh, I see Rager. Go! No! Did he catch it? I got to see that again. What happened there? Oh, he dropped it. All right, let's make something positive here, boys. 2nd and 10. Oh, man, I couldn't get it off in time. That's okay. It's okay. I say it's okay, but it's really not. It's 3rd and 19. Oh, I got R1. Oh, I hit the wrong button. He still almost caught it, but I hit the wrong man. That was my fault, man. Damn it. All right, I have faith that De La Haye can hit a 59-yarder. Perfect accuracy. Oh, he hit the crossbar. You guys let me know in the comments what I need to do on those field goal kicks, Devin White. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Doing that work out there. He is a beast. Flex on him. Crunch time here, boys. If we don't stop him here, we're going to be in some big trouble. Saquon, nowhere to go, baby. That's going to bring up 4th down. Nowhere to go. You know what? Just let that one bounce to the end zone. Come on, JT. Get us out of here. There we go, baby. Squirting through the hole. Picking up 10. Giving us some breathing room. All right, this is pick 6 territory, but we don't care. We don't care because we have Mike Evans. Who else? Okay, nice 7 yards. Show me some of the outside, JT. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Oh, I should have trucked. I should have trucked him. I know he can truck these guys for sure. Nice, nice run, though. We're driving on him now, boys. Let's get something going here. Very nice. Right over his head. Look at that. Look at him tiptoeing on the sideline, staying in bounds. That's what I'd love to see. You know, I have like a little bit of a phobia with throwing it down the field. I've had some guys open. Here we go, JT. Let's go. I think I trucked a little too early there. 3rd and short. Let's go, baby. Let's go. That's a 1st down. Let's get it. Fresh set of downs. 5 minutes to play. Man, if we can't score on this defense, man, we got problems because We got San Fran coming up next week. OJ Howard, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Love it, man. He's a beast. They wanted Jonathan Taylor's first career rushing touchdown. Let's get it for him. That's not going to do it. He's going to lose 5 on that one. That hurts badly. That was the rookie, A.J. Epenesa, as well, with his second TFL. Let's go, baby. Oh, I couldn't cut up in time. But Mike Evans gets us all those yards back, plus some. All right, our coach suggestions has us going for this. Let's get it, man. Come on, JT. Cut it up. Oh. All right, 3rd and 4. We have no more timeouts, but if we stop them here, we can get the ball back with some limited time. Who is that? Minkah Fitzpatrick, baby. Let's go. He's been doing that all throughout the preseason. All right, we need a nice return here from you, Trevion. Let's go. That'll do it. Just under a minute left to play, and Trevion has us at the 47-yard line. Very good field position. We're going to start it off with the 4 verticals. We'd love to win our first game, man. At least want to tie it here. OJ? He came down with it. He came down with it. Let's go. Let's keep it going. We're going to do it again. We're going to try to go to him again, but... Got... So, yeah, man, it got tipped up in the air for Fromm's first career interception. You can't really fault him too much for that. Was that a safety? No, that was not a safety. But, yeah, man, I mean, you can't really fault him. They're not going to run this play. Can't fault him too much for that, man, honestly. You know, he had a good game otherwise. I feel like he had a very good game otherwise. We only came out here with 6 points, which hurts a little bit. It really hurts my pride a little bit, but and there goes the clipboard. Arians is not happy. Still, it wasn't the worst game ever. We just could not get anything going on offense, and at times where we should have scored, we didn't. We had three very big opportunities to score a touchdown that ended up becoming either a field goal or a turnover because of turning it over on downs. Howard had it in his hands at the end of the game there. You see the stats. I mean, we played a better game than them statistically. So I'm still proud of our boys. So taking a look at Fromm's stats on the day, a 70.3 quarterback rating. He was 19 of 34. He had 277 yards, which is not bad at all in a debut. The 55% completion percentage, it could use some work, but it's his first game. Got to give him a little bit of a pass on that. He had the one pick, but, you know, there's never going to be asterisks next to picks, but, you know, that one was tipped up. JT, I was expecting a little bit more out of him, but again, like I said, it was his first game. He's just getting acclimated to the NFL. 22 attempts for 65 yards, a 2.9 average. So, like I said, he's just getting his feet wet too. Got to give him time to really get a feel for what the NFL is like. You know, he's still a rookie. He's still learning. Mike Evans, man, having a great game. He really had a great game. If you add a touchdown or two on that stat line, he had a, you know, player of the week type of game. 9 receptions for 101 yards. OJ Howard, 4 for 81. And then Shaheen with that great, great catch. 2 for 25. Rager 2 for 33, and then of course we had Scotty Miller and Chris Godwin with 1 reception apiece. The defensive side of the ball, it was our boy Minkah Fitzpatrick and Ronnie Harrison, both of our safeties with 10 tackles total on the day. They led the team. Shaq Barrett with 4 TFLs on the day. Devin White had himself 2 TFLs, and then Carl Nassib and Levante David with a TFL apiece. As far as sacks go, you had Devin White and Minkah Fitzpatrick each getting in the backfield, getting to the quarterback. And then, of course, as you guys know, we had no picks on the day. So we did actually reach our goal of, keeping them to 1 or fewer rushing touchdowns. They had none on the day. The only touchdown in the entire game was a touchdown pass to Golden Tate. But we contained Saquon Barkley pretty well. We just didn't get the win, which was the other part of the goal. So we start off the season 0-1. With a young team like ours, it's to be expected. Like I said, there's going to be some growing pains. We had some trouble getting into the end zone when we got close to the red zone or in the red zone. That was our biggest problem. Moving the ball wasn't that big of a problem, especially through the air. I feel like we moved the ball, you know, with some efficiency, but it was as soon as we got into that red zone, man, as soon as we got close to the goal line is where we started to struggle a lot. The only thing that worries me just a little bit is that we're going up against a true defensive juggernaut next week in the San Francisco 49ers, so it's not going to get any easier from there. However, we've got one regular season game under our belt. The chemistry should be better in week two, and we should be able to at least be competitive with the 49ers in that game in San Francisco. So I would love to hear from you guys in the comments what you think the game plan should be going into San Francisco, what things you think we should do different, what things we did not do well, and what things we did do well in week one. Being on All Madden, I know it's very, very difficult, especially because I got the sliders a little bit high, but I do want it to be challenging, so I'm not going to change anything. But I do want next week to be much, much different in terms of our red zone efficiency. And we will be back for week two, ready and better than ever to take on the San Francisco 49ers in San Fran. And more importantly, I'll have you guys right there behind me in the booth as we chase our first dub of the season. So nothing left to do now but to advance to the next week. And until week two, I will catch you guys next time.